Hi mga mamshi! Welcome back to Inay Badiday! And if this is your first time here in my channel, I'm Mom Shirosana. I'm a first-time mom. I was a former nurse in the Philippines, and now I'm a stay-at-home mom here in America with my husband and our son. And also, don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and hit the bell icon below for you to get notified on my next videos. So ayan mga mamshi, isi-share ko sa inyo yung my three sweet and simple reasons why we decided to co-sleep or bed share with our son. But before that, I'd like to emphasize that this is my personal opinion and this is my personal experience. And again, every mom, every parent, every situation, every family, every culture, and every child is different. This is not about comparison. This is not about judging parenting style or parents' choices. This is only to share my personal opinion and personal experience. Okay? So, mga mamshies, again, kagaya ng sinabi ko sa last vlog ko, yung last vlog ko pala about this topic is yung personal choices or opinions ng different moms about this topic. So, if hindi nyo pa pala napapanood, ayan, I leave the link above yung video na to for you to watch, mga mamshi. So, kagaya ng sinabi ko sa last vlog ko na let's just respect each other's mamshies or parents' choice about this topic. So, kung may mommy na nag-co-sleep or bed share or may mommy na nag-sleep train early, it's their choice or it's our choices. It's our own child. So, it's our child, our rules, sabi nga, diba? So, ayun. So, let's just respect each other. Kasi iba-iba naman tayo. So, ayun. So, dahil dyan, I will share with you na my experience. So, but before that, mga mamshi, I'd like to read some information with you about co-sleeping, cultural differences, and the benefits of co-sleeping. This is from verywellfamily.com. So, I will share this website link below for you to check out later for this reference. Okay? So, cultural differences. So, ito yung gusto kong i-share also. According to verywellfamily.com, there is no doubt that there is a difference in how well the practice of co-sleeping is accepted across cultures. So, ayan, Western culture largely has frowned on the arrangement, whereas co-sleeping seems to be the norm in other developing countries. Anthropologists have also noted a difference in the acceptance of the practice based on the general attitude of the society. Collectivist cultures, meaning cultures that place greater value on the good of the group as opposed to the individual, are more likely to co-sleep than societies that emphasize the individual. So ayun, gusto ko lang i-share sa inyo yung source na to, information na to about from verywellfamily.com. So it's just a backup knowledge and information about the cultural differences. So magkakaiba talaga. So for example, tayo sa Philippines, we grow up na talaga nagko-co-sleep tayo with our parents. Lumaki tayo na magkasama tayong lahat na natutulog sa isang kwarto. While here in the United States, it's very common naman na ang baby is naka-separate agad ng rooms from sa parents. So, it's just a cultural differences and let's just respect that, okay? So, ayan. So, ang next na i-share ko is yung the benefits of co-sleeping. So, here are the benefits of co-sleeping, again, from verywellfamily.com. According to verywellfamily.com, many parents, both those who specifically consider themselves to be attachment parents and those who do not, believe that shared sleep has many advantages. And these are some of the advantages. Infants who co-sleep go to sleep faster and stay asleep longer. So based on my experience, this is true for us, at least for us. So mas mahaba ang tulog namin pareho mag-ina nung nag-co-sleep kami. And then, next is more mother who co-sleep report feeling better rested, which is very true again for me based on my experience. When we co-sleep, mas mahaba ang tulog ko. Ayan. And better and well rested ako. So, ayan. And it promotes breastfeeding by making night feeding quicker, less disruptive, and more accessible. So, again, so nag-breastfeed ako from newborn. Ayan. Newborn hanggang sa 8 months. So, hanggang 8 months ako nag-breastfeed kay Logan. So, this is true for us. Again, for me, mas easier for me yung pag-breastfeed kasi hindi ko na kailangan magpatakbo-takbo sa room and then balik sa room. So, ayun. So, very easier and convenient for me talaga yung naka-co-sleep ang setup namin kay Logan. And then, some research suggests that infants who co-sleep have stronger emotional relationships with their parents and with other people. So, ayan. So, emphasize ko to later sa next, sa three reasons why ko. And then, co-sleeping advocates also point to research that suggests when parents take sleep safety precautions, it reduces the risk of sudden infant death syndrome. I think this is true as long as the parents take sleep safety precautions. This will prevent or reduce the risk of SIDS or sudden infant death syndrome. So, ayan. So, that's it. Ang shinare ko lang sa inyo ang some information about this, mga mamshies. So, let's start. But before that, before ko simulan or i-share sa inyo ang three sweet and simple reasons why we decided to co-sleep with our son, I will also first recommend and highly recommend for you to watch the vlog or video of Mamshi Donna about sleep training. So, if you decided if you want to sleep train your baby, I highly recommend you to watch this video, mga mamshies. Watch nyo to. And I'm sure I really, really, really highly recommend kasi I'm very sure na you will get a lot of information and helpful tips from Mamshi Donna based on her experience about sleep training. Ayan. So, ayan mga mamshi. Here's my three sweet and simple reasons why we co-sleep with our baby. First, we want to cherish every moment that our child is still a baby or a kid or a toddler. And I will back up this from Healthline.com. According to Healthline.com, reality check. The days are long, but the years are short, and these sweet snuggles are fleeting. As kids get older, they'll claim their independence and want more physical space. Co-sleeping while children are in the toddler stage enables you to make the most of this time. So again, this is my personal choice. So, I believe na one day, my son will tell me na, Mommy or Daddy, I'm ready na to sleep alone or I'm ready na to sleep on my own bed. I'm sure as they get older, they want physical space. I'm sure hindi naman habang buhay na makikitabi or makikitulog or kasama nyo sa bed ang anak nyo because lalaki sila or tatanda sila. And when they gets older, for me, I'm sure ito yung mamimiss ko. Yung magkatabi kami at magkasama kami sa higaan. So, I think magiging independent din siya when he is ready. Ayan. So that's my first reason why. Ayan. And the second reason why is we believe that co-sleeping strengthen our parent-child relationship. And I will back up this again from Healthline.com. So, according to Healthline.com, co-sleeping can help you bond on a deeper level and give your child a sense of safety and security. Ayan. So, and I definitely 100% agree about this. So, ayan. So, again, so we want to strengthen and build a very strong bond and relationship with our child. Ayan, so that's my second reason why. And so the third reason why. Third, my child is different. Simple, my child is different. So my child is different. Paulit-ulit. So why I said my child is different. Honestly, we tried to sleep train him because we are here in the United States and everybody, or I'm not saying everybody, but very common. Again, it's very common here na ini-sleep train talaga ang baby ng maaga. And also, my son's pediatrician always encouraging us to sleep train Logan early. Not forcing us, but always, whenever, every time na may appointment or checkup, she's always asking if Logan is sleeping alone na. So, it's kind of pressure for me at the same time. Kasi yung ganong question. So, that's why I tried. I tried my very best. So, here's the story. When Logan was still a newborn, infant, baby pa lang siya, we co-sleep. Again, magkaiba po yung co-sleep at bed sharing. At first month ni Logan, we co-sleep. Magkasama kaming lahat sa bedroom, pero nakaseparate si Logan sa bed namin. Nasa crib niya siya. Nasa bassinet. And I know the danger of bed sharing, especially if the baby is still infant. Okay? So, as a former nurse, and actually, I was a NICU nurse. So, talagang sa baby ako, nag-work dati, more on babies. So, as a NICU nurse, I know the danger of SIDS or sudden infant death syndrome. So, when we decided to co-sleep, I make sure talaga na I will provide a safe sleeping environment for my child. So, magkasama kaming lahat sa bedroom, pero nakaseparate siya sa kanyang bassinet, which is nasa side ko lang din. Okay? Yung bassinet, I make sure na yung bassinet walang ibang nakalagay. Walang kumot, walang unan, walang toys or anything, just him, just the baby, just si Logan lang. So that's how I provided the safe sleep environment for my baby. Again, just make sure to provide a safe sleep space for your baby. So yun yung first month namin, first month ni Logan, naka-co-sleep. And the second month ni Logan, it's mix of co-sleep and bed sharing. Again, nung nag-bed share ako sa kanya, hindi siya sa in-between namin. Hindi siya sa gitna ng asawa ko and ako. So, I make sure na si Logan nasa side ko, and even nasa side ko siya, walang masyadong mga unan or kumot or blanket na nakapaligid sa kanya. Or even sa akin, hindi ako masyadong nagba-blanket na. Even lamig na lamig ako. Kasi I wanted to make sure talaga to provide a safe sleep space for my son. And also, hindi ako deep matulog. Hindi rin ako malikot matulog. So, as sanay ako nang mabilis magising. So, sanay din ako na nagpupuyat. So, as mentioned, dati akong nurse, so sanay ako nagpupuyat, talagang 24 hours minsan or 18 hours, not 24 hours, 18 hours duty, tuloy-tuloy. So, talagang always awake ako, especially sa night. So, ayan. So, makatulog man ako, hindi super himbing. So, isa yun sa consideration ko din. Isa yun sa naging, parang, mag-bed share or co-sleep with my son. And, after two months, ayan. After 2 months, sabi ko, I will start to sleep train na si Logan. Ayan. So, after 2 months, again, if napanood yung video ko ng 24 hours with my 2 months baby, na-mention ko doon na i-sleep train ko na si Logan at 3 months, which I tried. Sinubukan ko talagang mag-sleep train. Ilagay siya sa kabilang kwarto, and then, patulugin. Ayan. And, iba yung anak ko. As in, pag umiyak talaga siya, as in bongga, as in to the highest level, as in to the highest level, mga mamshi. Yung ginagawa ko noon, nung baby pa si Logan, na 3 months na mag-start ako ng sleep training, so, be-breastfeed ko, and then, pag nakatulog na, ilalagay ko na siya sa kanyang crib. Okay, so nakatulog na, iiwanan ko na siya sa kwarto niya. A few minutes lang, mga mamshi, na iwanan ko, or siguro an hour lang na makatulog siya, grabe, to the highest level ang iyak niya. At ito yung anak ko, bakit siya different? Kasi pag umiyak talaga siya, as in sumusuka. So yung anak ko, mabilis siya sumuka. So ayun, sumusuka talaga siya, as in to the highest level din yung pagsuka niya talaga, as in buong katawan niya talaga. Grabe, pagbalik ko, pag-check ko sa kanya, talagang punong-puno na ng suka. Tapos yung pamumula ng anak ko, bongga, to the highest level, nagpa-patch-patch yung mukha niya pag umiiyak talaga. So, as a mommy, I feel so bad. I feel so guilty. So, again, every mom is different. And hindi ko nakayanan yun. Hindi ko nakayanan na ganun, na aabutan ko na ganun yung anak ko. So I tried na mag-sleep train, and actually every month yata ako nagta-try. First 3 months nagsubok ako, and then 4 months nagsubok na naman ako, 5 months niya nagsubok na naman ako. So I tried, mga mamshi, pero hindi talaga, it didn't work for us, it didn't work for my son. It just, instead na it will make us feel better or makatulog ng mas mahaba, hindi, it didn't. So I decided to stop, and ituloy-tuloy na lang yung pag co-sleeping, and we all sleep better. Mas nakatulog kami ng mahaba, mas nakatulog kami ng mahimbing. Again, because my son is different, or different siguro ako. So si Logan, yung anak ko, mas mahaba ang tulog kapag magkatabi kami, or at least magkasama kami sa room. So talagang mas at peace kami pareho, mas mahaba ang tulog namin pareho. So ayon. So that's why we decided na lang na, okay, let's stop the sleep training and let's just continue bed sharing or co-sleeping. So from first month, co-sleeping, second month, mix of co-sleeping and bed sharing, but again with safe sleep precautions and safe sleep space. And then 4 months, 5 months, mix of bed sharing and co-sleeping. And then as Logan gets older, 1 year old, ayan, nung mag 1 year old na si Logan, toddler na siya, ayan, tuloy-tuloy na yung bed sharing namin. Magkasama na talaga kami sa kwarto. So, kapag medyo old na yung baby, hindi na infant, nasa toddler age na, medyo less na yung risk of SID. So, that's it mga mamshi. Thank you so much for watching. And I hope may natutunan kayo today sa aking vlog. And I hope nakakuha kayo ng ideas. So, whatever you decide at the end of the day, it is your choice. It is your personal choice as a mommy or as a parent. So, ayan. And again, there's no right or wrong. Walang tama at walang mali. Kung ano yung gusto mo, kung ano yung mommy instinct mo, there's no right or wrong about it. If you want to co-sleep, bed share, or sleep train early, there's nothing wrong with that. Okay, mga mamshi? So, thank you so much again for watching. And if this is your first time here in my channel, please don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and hit the bell icon below for you to get notified on my next videos. Thank you so much. Happy mom life, happy parenting, and happy life. Bye-bye!